Hey guys, so after yesterday's video that I posted about how I apply my falsies, I had a few people ask me to do a tutorial on how I fill in my brows. As you can see, I have my whole entire face done with my makeup. The only thing that's not done is my brows, and I think that for me is an important thing to do. I rarely leave the house without at least filling them in a little bit because I don't have a lot of hair on my eyebrows, so I don't have very full eyebrows, which I kind of envy girls that do. But eyebrows next to lashes are my must-haves. I have to do them or else I feel like I look like a complete idiot when I leave the house. So today I'm gonna fill in my brows for you. I'm gonna try my best to get close enough so you guys can see what I'm doing. So let's get started.
Are you really just gonna sit there and scream while I film this?
Okay guys, so let's get started. The first thing that I do every single day when I do my brows is I brush them out with a little spoolie type thing, or however the hell you say it. This is just off of the end of one of my old eyeliners that I use, so I just keep it for that, honestly. And then after that, I'll just go in with one of my angled brushes. This one is a double-sided brush from Unique, I believe. And I will take a matte eyeshadow. This eyeshadow is from BH Cosmetics. It's just a dark brown. I just use one that matches my hair color the best. I don't really have a specific one, but when I start my brows, I start at the almost close to the middle. I like to be pretty close to the natural shape of my brows, even though I really don't have any brows. I just start at the bottom and then I will go towards the beginning of my brow after most of the excess of the product has come off. I like to be light-handed at the start of my brows because I don't like to have my eyebrows boxy looking. So I will just swipe up in a feather-like motion to try and create the illusion that I have hair. So I will be light-handed at the start, and then I will get a little bit more heavy-handed and have a little bit more product on my brush at the end of my eyebrow. I do have to create my own arches because I don't have hair that grows up there, even though there should be. So I have to create my own, and sometimes my brows come out looking kind of crazy because sometimes they don't match and it's kind of frustrating, but more practice makes perfect, right? I'll only dip my brush in my eyeshadow probably maybe two or three times, and then the rest of it basically is just brushing through my brows, kind of blending out that eyeshadow. I don't like to be too heavy, like I said before. I just like to have them look natural, look like I have hair, when I really don't. I mean, I really don't have very good eyebrows, but I mean, look at the difference in that. That's insane. That's crazy. Brows literally shape your face, and I'm a firm believer in that. So on my other eyebrow, I'm just gonna do the exact same thing that I did on my left eyebrow. Just gonna start at the bottom. I always start at the bottom of my eyebrow. I feel like I get the best results that way. You don't have to do it that way. It's totally up to you how you wanna do it, but that's my personal preference, and it works for me, so do whatever works for you. I call you too much. Never pick up, except when you wanna. Man, I can't get enough. You're the man of my dreams, cause you know how to leave. But I really believe that you're changing for me. And this is me just blending all of that eyeshadow around. I got a tiny bit at the tip of that brush so that I could swipe up in feather-like motions. Really, really, really softly. I'm not heavy-handed on this at all because I don't want the outcome to be a federal emergency either, so. And that's how I fill in my brows. My brows are pretty much done at this point. After I get all the color on them, I will go back in with eyebrow hairspray, but it's eyebrow gel. This one's from Rimmel. It's just called Brow This Way. I'll just take some, and at the start of my brow, I will brush literally directly up towards the sky. And then when I get to the middle of my brows, I'll swipe, you know, I'll brush them a little bit to the left, to the outer part of my face. When I do swipe up, when I brush them upwards, some of my hairs will stick up past the borderline of the top of my brow. So I will just take a little pair of scissors and I will just trim them so that it looks perfect. And I do that on both of my eyebrows. After I trim those, I just go back over it one more time with some eyebrow hairspray. This stuff is the bomb. I can't leave the house without this either. And I do the exact same thing on the other eyebrow too. Okay, after I'm done doing that, I will go in with a concealer brush. This one is from e.l.f. And I will take some concealer. Today I'm using e.l.f. concealer in the lightest shade that they have possible. It's not that light, but it's the lightest I can find. I will just take a little bit on my brush, just directly from the applicant. And I'm just gonna go underneath my brow and just clean up and try and make it look perfect, like I said, once again. I like my brows to look clean and sharp. And I'll just blend that out. I call you too much. I don't really do it at the top of my brows. I mainly stick to underneath my brow, right at the start of my brow too. That's mainly where I have a lot of problems, where sometimes I'll be a little crazy and I won't have a straight of a line that I want. So that concealer trick is amazing and I love to do that. After that, I'm gonna go in with my Modern Renaissance palette. And I'm gonna go in with this gorgeous color. I use this color to highlight my brow bone. I always highlight my brow bone at brow bone after I do my eyebrows. And I'm just gonna go in with a shader brush that's on the opposite side of my liner brush that I use for my eyebrows. And I highlight that bone. I highlight that shit. That completes the whole entire look to me. I cannot stress enough how amazing it is to highlight your brow bone. For me personally, if you don't like to do that, it's totally fine. But for me, I like to be extra at all times, so I highlight the crap out of that thing and I'll take it to my inner corner because it's just beautiful. Beautiful color. After I've gotten everything done, my makeup's completely done, highlight and everything, I'll go in with a setting spray. This is by Milani. It's called Make It Last. I think it is a matte finish. I am absolutely in love with this stuff. It's from the drugstore. It smells amazing and I have to bathe myself in it every single time. And it makes my makeup last throughout the day and I love the way it sets. And that's how I do my brows. I'm so sorry that the lighting wasn't that good. This shows you a little bit more of an idea. I'm gonna do better next time, I promise, guys. Thanks for watching.